surface tension.
Now, so far we discussed about the theory of a Quincke's drop method. Now, let us do the experiment. For that, we require the travelling microscope to measure the heights. For the travelling microscope, the least count is 0.001 centimeter. That is given by, that formula is least count equal to 1 by n into 1 MSD, value of 1 MSD, main scale division. Number of divisions in the vernier scale is 50 and value of 1 MSD is 0.05 centimeter. Therefore, it is equal to 0.001 centimeter or 0.001 into 10 power minus 2 meter. This is the least count of a travelling microscope. Now, let us do the experiment. Take a large drop of mercury on a clean glass plate. S is the source of light. P1, P2 is a glass plate inclined at 45 degree to the horizontal. So, this is the experimental arrangement. This is the Quincke's drop. To find the point of most protruding part, glass plate is placed at a 45 degree. So, it will reflect and you can exactly locate the point of most protruding point, and that is viewed by a microscope. So, a microscope is adjusted in the top surface of drop and note the reading. Then lower the microscope gradually and bring it to the position where the light reflected by the drop is maximum. At I, that is the most protruding point, at I the surface of drop is vertical and the beam of light is incident on its reflected back horizontally. At other positions the reflection take place in other directions. Lower the microscope and note the reading R3 corresponding to the glass surface. Now, these are the readings. R1 equal to 6.512 into 10 power minus 2 meter, R2 equal to 6.250 into 10 power minus 2 meter, R3 is 6.167 into 10 power minus 2 meter. Therefore, H is equal to 0.345 into 10 power minus 2 meter, small h equal to R1 minus R2, that is equal to 0.262 into 10 power minus 2 meter. Now, these are the observations in our experiment. Small h equal to 0.262 into 10 power minus 2 meter. Let density of mercury rho equal to 13,600 kilogram per meter cube. Acceleration due to gravity is 9.8 meter per second square. Then what is the value of surface tension of mercury? Now, we have derived this formula. If you know the value of h, you can calculate surface tension. Surface tension T equal to 1 by 2 h square rho g. Now, inserting the values for h, rho, g, you can get the surface tension of mercury is 0.457 Newton per meter. So, only with the help of small h, we can calculate the surface tension of mercury. Now, how will you calculate the angle of contact for mercury and glass? For angle of contact, we need two parameters, h and small h. H equal to 0.345 into 10 power minus 2 meter, small h equal to 0.26 into 10 power minus 2 meter, and alpha can be calculated by this formula. Cos alpha equal to h square by h square minus 1, here alpha is 43 degree. So, alpha is 43 degree, therefore, the angle of contact is 180 minus 43, that is equal to 137 degree. So, in our experiment, we have determined the value of surface tension of mercury with the glass and the angle of contact for mercury and glass, that is 137 degree. These are the results. The distance of the top flat surface of the drop from the horizontal surface of minimum area h. H is independent of the size of the drop, but it depends only upon the nature of liquid and angle of contact. And we can prove this by this equation. T equal to h square rho g by 2 1 plus cos alpha. Therefore, from this you find h equal to 2 cos alpha by 2 square root of T by rho g. Therefore, all drops of a liquid resting on a horizontal solid plate which they do not wet must have the same height. So, for all mercury drops, irrespective of the size of the drop, whether it is big or small, it do not wet must have the same height. It means the height of the drop is same. That is capital H and small h. So, this is the conclusion from the Quincke's drop method. The height of the drop is independent of the size of the drop. To test your understanding, let me ask one question. This is a question: liquid drops are slowly falling one by one from a vertical glass plate. Establish the relation between the weight of the drop W, the surface tension T, and the radius of the tube. Assume the angle of contact is 0. So, what are the equations? You are giving 4 options. A, W equal to pi r square T. B, W equal to 2 pi r square T. C, W equal to 4 by 3 pi r cube T. D, W equal to 2 pi r T. So, based on the theories learned in this episode, you can answer the question very easily.